As an advanced medical practitioner pharmacist practicing in family medicine, the topic of weight and visceral fat is often not discussed enough when it comes to cardiovascular health and blood pressure. So in today's video, I'm going to be discussing why does being overweight increase your blood pressure? Why does that actually happen? Also, we're going to discuss practical ways that everyone can do to help lower your blood pressure naturally at home. And we're also going to discuss about a few things that a lot of people don't know when it comes to taking your blood pressure that can actually cause incorrect readings. So make sure to watch the whole video because it's going to have some really, really useful information. Now, before we go into the details about weight and blood pressure, let's first talk about body mass index. We call it BMI for short. Now, when it comes to BMI, the way I want you to think about it is a very simple way of checking if your weight is in a healthy status or not. I particularly like BMI because it's really easy to calculate. Everyone can do it straight away. It's basically your weight in kilograms divided by your height in meters squared. So the main reason that I particularly like BMI is it gives us a really easy way to figure out if you are in an overweight category or obese category, because both of them have very strong links to increased blood pressure, increased risk of cardiovascular disease, and also increased risk of type 2 diabetes. But it is really important to make sure that you have a working weighing scale. I have seen it so many times in my very own clinical practice. I ask patients for an up-to-date weight. They're using their weighing scales from 30, 40 years ago that was passed down to them, and unfortunately the weighing scales are not giving accurate readings, usually showing less weight than they actually are, and that's obviously going to give us an incorrect BMI reading. Okay, so we don't have an accurate representation of their BMI, so we don't know what their health status is like. Now, it is important to remember though that BMI is just one measurement. Okay, it doesn't take into account things like your muscle mass. Okay, I actually did my dissertation on BMI, so it's an area which I am very clued up on. Unfortunately, it doesn't look at that, but overall is a good indicator. Now, if you do want to find out more things about your body rather than just your BMI, you can find out things like your muscle mass, your visceral fat, your body fat index by using the A&D Medical Body Composition Weighing Scale. So it's able to give you your weight, of course, but also all of your body composition, like your muscle mass, like your visceral fat, like your body fat index, and it's all nicely put on charts, so it's easy for you to read. It's connected to the A&D Heart Track app as well, which makes it super simple for you to monitor it. So I guess the next question is, why does being overweight increase our blood pressure? Well, when you're carrying excess weight, your heart has to pump a lot harder to move and circulate that blood around the body. And this increased workload puts additional increased stress on your blood vessels, which basically causes them to narrow, increasing the blood pressure. And this is the major reason why those who have a higher BMI generally have a higher blood pressure reading. And basically, the more weight that you carry, the greater strain on your cardiovascular health system. So I guess the next question is, what happens when you lose weight? The good news is that when you do lose weight, your blood pressure will naturally drop. And studies have shown that losing just a modest amount of weight, so losing about 5 to 10% of your current body weight, can have a significant drop in your blood pressure. And this is an important note to remember. Basically, the more overweight you are, the impact will be far more when you lose weight, basically, compared to just being a little overweight. So that's just a good point to remember as well. In terms of numbers for weight loss, okay, so for every 1 kilogram you lose, 1 kilogram is about 2.2 pounds for those watching in the United States. So for every 2.2 pounds or 1 kilogram that you lose, you're expected to drop your blood pressure by about 1 to 2 millimeters of mercury. So I know that doesn't sound like a lot when you're thinking it in terms of 1 kilogram or just 2.2 pounds, but imagine if you drop 10 kilograms, okay? So imagine if you lose 10 kilograms, which is about 22 pounds. Well, you're probably looking at a 10 to 20 millimeter of mercury reduction in blood pressure, which is very impressive. But not only that, it's gonna reduce your cardiovascular risk as well. So we're gonna get massive benefits from doing this. So I guess the next question is, what should you eat then to help lower your blood pressure and help you lose weight? I'm gonna talk about the DASH diet now. This is basically a diet specifically for high blood pressure. So DASH stands for Dietary Approach to Stop Hypertension. And this diet isn't just about weight loss. It also focuses on foods that are healthy for your heart as well and for your cardiovascular system. So let's run through it and learn how you do it. So let's begin with fruit and veg. As part of the DASH diet, you should be having 4 to 5 servings of fruit and 4 to 5 servings of vegetables every single day, okay? We're gonna get so many minerals from this. These foods are rich in potassium, magnesium, and fiber, all of which are gonna help us lose weight, and they're also also going to help with blood pressure. Think of it like this: fill half of your plate with fruit and half of your plate with veg every single meal. Moving on to whole grains, aim for 6 to 8 servings every single day. These include foods like brown rice, oats, and quinoa. Whole grains. The beauty of whole grains is they're loaded with fiber. They keep you full for longer, which is all going to help us lose weight. Third thing we're going to discuss is lean protein. So you need to aim for about 2 servings of lean protein every single day. This includes things like skinless chicken, fish, beans, and nuts. The fourth thing we're going to discuss is dairy. So you're going to aim for about 2 to 3 servings of dairy every single day. If you can, try and get the lower fat cheese or the yogurt, but don't go for the sugary stuff. Basically, don't go for the sweetened, artificial flavored yogurts. Just go for the natural stuff as much as you can. Next, we're going to talk about nuts and seeds. So you're going to aim for about 4 to 5 servings of these every single week. Again, these are very rich in fiber, so they can help keep us full for longer, and they're going to basically help us lose more weight. Now, in order to do the DASH diet correctly, you need to limit your sweets and added sugars, basically. Okay, we're talking no more than 5 servings every single week. So what does this mean? It basically means cutting back on the sugary snacks, on the sodas that you're having, on the sugar that you might be adding to your coffee, anything like that, you need to cut down on it. And lastly, let's talk about sodium. The DASH diet is well known to recommend a low sodium intake, no more than 2,300 milligrams of sodium per day. Ideally, you're talking about 1,500 milligrams for those who have high blood pressure. In terms of how much salt that is, we're talking about 3.75 to 5.75 grams every single day. Sodium plays a key role in increasing your blood pressure, so make sure to keep it low, try and cook from scratch, avoid ready meals, and also maybe look at using herbs and spices to bring a bit of flavor. And like I said earlier, the beauty of the DASH diet is we're not only just focusing on weight loss. By doing the DASH diet, it's also going to help improve our cardiovascular health. Now, to help you stay on track, I cannot recommend using our A&D Medical body composition scale. It has 4 precision sensors for ease and accuracy when you're taking your weight measurements. And best of all, it's able to pair with our A&D HeartTrack app, so you can keep all of your results as well as your body composition results on your phone, and you can access it and also see the trends, see how much weight you're losing, and see how you're getting on. One thing that I really like about the A&D HeartTrack app as well, as a medical provider, when patients show me their results on there, I can easily see them and review all the results. You can download the A&D HeartTrack app today. It's completely free. You can get it from Google Play or the Apple App Store. So moving on, the next thing I want to discuss is your blood pressure monitor, and specifically your cuff size, okay? If your cuff doesn't fit you correctly, all right? So let's say, for example, it's too small for you. It can overestimate your blood pressure by about 5 to 20 millimeters of mercury, which is a massive amount. And by the way, the same rule applies. If your cuff is too big, it can underestimate your blood pressure by about 3.6 millimeters of mercury. So I guess what I'm trying to say with this is if your cuff size isn't fitting right, then it could lead to incorrect diagnosis of high blood pressure, or incorrect treatment being started, or treatment not being started if your blood pressure is too high. And in fact, this has happened to me personally in clinic when I see patients plenty of times. I once had a patient who I'd asked to do 7-day home blood pressure readings for me. They brought in the readings, and for some reason, their average blood pressure reading was about 15 millimeters of mercury higher than what I was getting in clinic. So I asked them to come in and to bring their blood pressure monitor, obviously, in with them as well. We checked it, we used their blood pressure monitor, and I did it with my blood pressure monitor. And again, I saw that the blood pressure was far higher on their monitor. And after I looked at their cuff, I noticed that actually this cuff that they were using was basically too small for their arm. So it was basically overestimating the blood pressure. Now, what I want you to think about is, let's say I didn't have the time to bring in that patient and to see how they're using their monitor and to actually look at their monitor as well. And I just went off those readings. Well, if I went off those readings, then I may have diagnosed that patient with high blood pressure. Also, we call it hypertension. I may have started them on treatment. So all of this could have been prevented if their cuff size was correct. And this leads me on very nicely to discuss our A&D blood pressure monitors. Most of our blood pressure monitors, they come with what we call advanced cuff fit detection. and also movement detection, okay? So if your cuff isn't fitting correctly, you're gonna see that symbol that's popping up on screen. Again, if you're moving too much, the movement detection thing's gonna come up on screen as well. So it's making you aware that something's wrong, so your results might not be accurate. Now, when it comes to blood pressure, it's not only weight loss that will help lower your blood pressure. There are other things that you can do that will naturally help lower your blood pressure as well. We do have a video where we go through loads of different things in far more detail, but I'll briefly give you a few right now. So first up, let's start with exercise. Aim for 30 minutes of moderate intensity exercise every single day. So you can start off with just going for a gentle walk, and then you can try and speed it up. You can go for a jog, cycle, anything like that will be really useful. Secondly, stress management, okay? We need to try and reduce our cortisol levels. Cortisol will spike our blood pressure, okay? So look at doing things to help make you calm and relax, okay? Yoga, meditation, just doing gentle stretches throughout the day. All of these can be really helpful. Thirdly, we have sleep and hydration, all right? You need to be aiming for about 8 to 9 hours of sleep every single night, but also, is the quality of sleep good, okay? We go through this in a lot more detail in our other videos if you want to learn about sleep quality. And again, hydration, you know, aiming for 6 to 8 glasses of water every single day and reducing our caffeine as well. Thank you so much for watching our video today. We really hope that you found this information helpful. To learn more about A&D Medical and our fantastic products, from our body composition weighing scale to our blood pressure monitors, please do visit our website to learn more. And as the inventors of the digital home blood pressure monitor in 1977, here at A&D Medical, we definitely know how to get the most accurate readings. On our YouTube channel, we focus on cardiovascular health. We talk about many different topics as well, so definitely do check them out on how to lower your blood pressure naturally, as well as doing different experiments to show how doing certain things incorrectly will give you incorrect blood pressure readings. So it's definitely a fun watch. Definitely give them a watch as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you know someone who'll find this information helpful, please share it to them. And as we always say at the end of every single video, A&D Medical, discover precision.